Es que las personas que conoces, tu network, tu red de contactos, es tan importante como quién eres tú, lo que sabes, de dónde vienes. Así que este evento debe ser una oportunidad para todos nosotros, para conectar con gente que pensamos de manera muy similar, que yo creo muchos de nosotros tenemos al menos esa inquietud de saber más de cómo contribuir al ambiente que tenemos alrededor, por ejemplo, de cómo proponer ideas y materializarlas, y como ya mencionábamos antes, de ponerlo al servicio de todos. Así que quiero que tomen un minuto y le den la mano, saluden a la persona que están al lado de ustedes, que no conozcan, digan su nombre. Hola, me llamo Alfredo. No sé, si no habla español, háganle el cuento que saben inglés. Pero por un segundo, preséntense y digan su nombre. Es importantísimo, especialmente aquí, que somos tantas personas que pensamos que podemos tener la solución alimentaria a varios problemas a nivel internacional. ¿De dónde vienen? ¿Qué color les gusta? No les pregunte su número todavía, pero por favor, presente. Muy bien, perfecto. Pues mantengan ese espíritu a lo largo del evento de hoy, porque aquí hay mucha gente que es muy valiosa. Quién sabe, quizás sea su cofundador, quizás sea algún compañero de negocios, alguien que pueda convertirse en un cliente en un futuro, quién sabe. Bueno, con esto quiero darle la bienvenida también al siguiente equipo. Su nombre es Apli RNA y quiero que les den un muy fuerte aplauso.
Pathogenic viruses there are infecting crops in the world? About 700, of which 160 exist in Mexico, producing big impact, reflected as losses of 40 to 100% for small and big producers. Plant viruses can cause economic reduction in production and also having an impact on food quality. As they cannot be controlled chemically, their management relies on early detection. And that is why we have brought to you guys our first prototype developed by our team, which is our AmpliRNA system. And this has been tested for 7 viruses in 4 different crops, and it's so easy to use. 4 steps: sampling, tissue maceration, 1 hour reaction, and voila, you have the detection colorimetrically. Our advantages are that it's a quick detection system for the field. It is so easy to use, there is no equipment needed and no special training. Above all, it has a low cost of 100 pesos or $5. If we take papaya as an example, Mexico produces about 3 million plants, which need about 1 million tests to detect viruses. Another striking example is the production of tomato with a really devastating virus that infects plants in greenhouses and the field. And that's in a production of about 300 million plants with the need of about 1.5 million tests. So we plan either to sell our product, transfer the technology, or license or sell our patent. If we envisage that we have about 100 crops in the region, we plan to have on a 5-year time about 80 customers that will require 1,200 tests per year, and our cost, that would mean a revenue of about 9.5 million pesos, translated into $500,000. That's per virus, per crop. We do have competitors that have products at least 2 to 10 more times the cost, and some of them taking longer to detect. Our team are Blanca, Natsu, and myself with experience on plant virology and entrepreneurship. And please imagine that viruses could be easily and accurately detected on the field with a low cost to the farmer. Join us to help to develop our next version of the prototype to solve a problem in the agri-food ecological system. Thank you very much.
So, how work intensive or labor intensive it is to go about testing each leaf of a plant to determine whether it has virus? And how do you intend to manage that?
Well, you have to collect the sample and then wrap them up, send them by email to the lab, and then wait for 2 to 3 days to get the results back. Is that your question?
The question was, there are several plants on the field, so are you testing one plant to determine the impact of the virus on the rest of the other plants, or are you testing each plant to determine the impact of the virus on each plant?
One plant at a time.
And do you have to develop a new test per crop, or does it scale to multiple different crops at the same time?
Oh, you have to scale it up on the lab first, and then go, but probably ambition doing it multi-channel. If we get to develop to the next station, probably prototype.
Okay. I guess what I mean would be like just for papaya, or would it be for papaya and maize and all everything at the same time, or ideally?
One crop.
Okay.
Yeah, just one virus and one crop at a time, and be easily adapted to other viruses and crops.
Thank you.
Perfecto. Bueno, me parece que ahora tenemos un video de parte de producción.